Roll credits. Season 2 of our very own global reality show is drawing to a close, and what a series of episodes it has been here in Donald Trump's America 2017. Episode 1, biggest inauguration crowd ever, was followed by fake news. Sad, finished, the Trumbull transcript, Lordy, I hope there are tapes. Someone bring me a Cov FIFA and go jump, Rocket Man, to name a few Emmy-worthy episodes. Strap in, as we deliver you America in Review, 2017. One Cov Ferrum Ferrum, it's the tweet that stopped the nation. Despite the negative press attention, Cov FIFA. But what did it mean? Press Secretary Sean Spicer claimed it was more than an innocent typo and that just a small group of people knew the meaning. What is that meaning? Some claimed it could be Samoan. The now deleted tweet will live on. Anyone for a Cov FIFA? Two Wires tapped another tweet that sent the world into a spin, allegations from the president that he was wiretapped by the Obama administration. On a familiar theme, Mr. Trump then claimed there were recordings of his conversations with FBI Director James Comey, to which the director said, Lordy, I hope there are tapes. This is now a t-shirt, truth. Three Puerto Ricans want everything done for them. Puerto Ricans are still battling the effects of Hurricane Maria, which hit the island way back in September. The U.S. government was criticized at the time for its slow and inadequate response to the storm, which wiped out power and water supplies for 3.5 million people. Donald Trump seemed to grapple with the fact that although they don't live on the U.S. mainland, Puerto Ricans are Americans. For and, the president has a go at Ani, and gets a reply. One National Security Advisor Michael Flynn. The first key scalp in the new administration, Michael Flynn lasted just 25 days, but his influence lingers. He's since been charged under the Russia investigation for lying to the FBI and will cooperate with the probe via a plea deal. What does he know? That will form part of Series 3. To White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer. From the first moment Sean Spicer stood behind the podium in an ill-fitting suit and propagated a sad lie about the size of the crowd on Inauguration Day, we knew he'd be a press secretary to remember. What followed was months of reprimanding and fighting with the White House press corps. Spicer became renowned not only for his mistruths but for his innovative approach to the English language, mashing so many words together that he ended up making new ones. 3 White House Communications Director Anthony Scaramucci. The demise of Sean Spicer, and Chief of Staff Reece Priebus, was accelerated by the arrival of Anthony Scaramucci. The mooch, like a shooting star, appeared in the White House universe before burning out just 10 days later. In a glaring mistake for any White House Communications Director, Scaramucci's downfall was attributed to an explosive interview with The New Yorker, in which he failed to discern the difference between on the record and off the record. The interview delivered some of the lines of the year, including